Mobile games have become a part of the larger gaming sphere whether we want them to or not. You can find them everywhere on your phone, your friends' phones, and even your parents' phones. How do companies make so many games? Well, we're going to look into some of the more shady and dark secrets mobile app developers don't want you to know. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to TheGamer and ring that bell to become a part of our notification squad so you never miss a video. Without further ado, here are 5 dark secrets about mobile games the developers won't admit. Copy and paste games. It's no secret that mobile games take less time to develop compared to console and PC games. The software might be simpler, and the hardware they're running on is not a game system or a powerful computer, but a tiny mini-computer people put in their pocket. It's no wonder, then, that the simple-to-play mobile games can become oversaturated and extremely repetitive. Let's look at one mobile game studio. King. They're responsible for the massively popular and addicting Candy Crush Saga. The game's a simple Bejeweled-style game with a candy theme reminiscent of Candyland, but is legally distinct from Candyland to avoid any lawsuits. The thing is, after Candy Crush Saga, King would come out with Diamond Digger Saga, Candy Crush Soda, Candy Crush Jelly, Bubble Witch, Bubble Witch 2 and 3, and so on and so on. These games play pretty much the same, with a few alterations to make them distinct enough to warrant a new game. It's not just King, but many other app developers will also make reskins and clones to crowd the market with poorly made games. These games are mostly free, but while they might seem free to play, they come with not so hidden and not so little costs. Freemium games. Candy Crush and Clash of Clans have one thing in common. They're both free to play. You can download them right now and begin playing without having to buy a thing. Or do you? While the concept of free-to-play games is not new, mobile games popularized a payment structure within these games dubbed freemium. It's the concept that a free-to-play game can have in-game purchases to get bonus content or resources. With Clash of Clans, you can buy gems to instantly upgrade or build buildings and get more resources. In Candy Crush, you can get one-time use power-ups for less than a dollar. Neither of these things are needed inherently to beat the game, but after a few hours or even a few minutes, you'll be hit with a stone wall where you're given a choice. Grind really hard to get past this level or pay a measly 99 cents to get past it via a power-up. No big deal, right? What's one measly dollar or two to get past this one part? Well, after you somehow spend $100, you'll understand why in-app purchases account for about 80% of the revenue for mobile app developers. Why do it though? Because once you start making menial progress, you just can't stop. Which leads us into... marketed to be addicting. We like to think that we're in control of our faculties, but in reality, we're slaves to patterns, heuristics, and our own mind. Gaming is fun. We enjoy playing games, and the longer we play, the more we enjoy. Most of the time, anyway. This is why we can sink 100+ hours into an RPG or play a game multiple times and still find enjoyment, because at the end of the day, we get a dopamine response from our brains. Dopamine, to put it very simply, is the chemical in your brain that gets released when you do something you like, such as eating your favorite food, playing your favorite game, or whatever. Mobile games have hyper-condensed this process and maximized player retention while minimizing effort. Basically, with a game that's just barely fun but very rewarding for making menial progress, they can keep players hooked for a long time. Couple that with the occasional microtransaction and boom, you have an addicting product aimed at slowly sapping away a person's money over a long period of time. Multiply that by a couple million and congratulations, you've now become a successful mobile app developer. Shameless stealing. But what if you don't want to get into all that psychology and brain chemistry and just want to make a quick buck and don't really care how you do it? Well, you could just steal assets and entire games, for starters. This can be found in all facets of media. The bootleg, pirated movies, knockoff films meant to imitate successful films, bootleg games for virtually every console, even shoes and clothes are some of the most common knockoff items. There is no end in sight for the black market of bootleg products, and the App Store is no exception. We all remember the infamous Flappy Bird, the game which took the mobile gaming world by storm way, way back in the day. Well, the game used a few familiar assets from Nintendo, and after being slapped with a cease and desist letter, it was quickly removed from the App Store. However, Flappy Bird was not the first or the last knockoff game to be featured on App Stores. No game franchise is safe from having shameless ripoffs. Mario, Pokemon, Final Fantasy, Kingdom Hearts, they've all had their poorly made, poorly translated games made into knockoff games shady developers push on the marketplace to make a quick buck or two. Celebrity plugging. We've been seeing more of this recently, but the concept is as old as popular media itself. When a celebrity endorses or puts their name on a product, fanatics will flock and buy it in droves. We've seen this with biographies of celebrities, products, and clothes. We've even seen it with board games in the form of the Donald Trump board game from the 80s. Today, celebrities are endorsing and creating their own apps. You may have heard from your mother's tabloid, but Kim Kardashian made her own mobile game where you play as a rising star and try to make it in Hollywood. The app is about as lifeless and empty as KK herself, but other celebrities who have endorsed apps in the past include Tom Hanks, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, Conan O'Brien, and Taylor Swift. Getting a celebrity to endorse a game or app is one of the easiest marketing gimmicks out there because depending on who the celebrity is, you can bet a large portion of their fan base will buy it, no questions asked. And those were just some of the more unsightly things mobile app developers have done. What do you think of mobile games? Do you love them? Do you hate them? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to TheGamer to see more exciting gaming content. Thanks for watching.